President has in political or in terms of specific pieces of the legislation, what leverage does the president have with Democrats?
In terms of getting the agenda forward?
Well, I would say, one, it's a hugely popular package. Each item in itself, that's why I went through some of the specifics here, has broad support among
the American public. But I would also say that if you talk to most Democrats who are in Congress, most Democrats in the country, there's not disagreement about the fundamentals of what we're trying to achieve. And there is agreement that we need to address the climate crisis, that we need to cut costs for childcare, for college, that we need to make it easier for women to rejoin the workforce. We need to rebuild and modernize our infrastructure. So there's agreement on that. There's a basic discussion that needs to happen or is ongoing. We're right in the weeds of it now on what the size of the package looks like. But I will also note, and we've done this a little bit over the past couple of days, but that this package, the reconciliation package, would cost $0. So what I'm saying, the case we're making here is that there needs to be agreement on the different components. There's broad agreement on the goals. And then there needs to be agreement on what the revenue pay-fors are. There's a range of options for revenue pay-fors. Clearly, the president has laid out the different areas that he would like to invest in, and all of that needs to come together. That's where we're in the weeds on now.
Is it a political problem for the president that he's having difficulty bringing together his own party?
First of all, we're in the process now. The president, again, doesn't underestimate how challenging getting all of these pieces of legislation forward is. We're in the middle of it right now. And there is broad agreement about the different components of his agenda. So what he's working to do now is unify the party around the path forward. That's what we're in the middle of. I don't think it's a little too early to evaluate how it's going to end.
He said it could go into next week. That's your expectation?
We'll see.
Go ahead. I'll come back to you, Jay.
Some reporting today that the White House and Democrats are considering or at least looking at means testing for some of the items in the reconciliation bill. Is that something that you would consider?
Well, it depends on how you define what that exactly is, right? There are income requirements for a range of different components of the president's agenda, right?
College, for example, that was billed as something that would be available to all Americans.
Right, but I'm not going to negotiate all the specifics from here. I'm just going to give you just a broad case understanding of how we've already approached things to date. Depends on how you're describing exactly what that is, right? We don't give the child tax credit. Every family is not eligible for the child tax credit in the country. Every person is not eligible for the earned income tax credit. There are income requirements for a variety of components. So there are some who have proposed that. Obviously, the president, there are components, as you can see from his past agenda, where there has been income tops on some components of his agenda. But beyond that, there are ongoing discussions right now.